Hello guys, and welcome back to my Let's Play of Jagged Alliance 2 version 1.13. This is part 61, and in this part we are going to take a short break from the fighting after two monstrously long episodes of combat. We do have some other things to do too, and I think now's the time to take a small break, 1 hour break from our attack to get things repaired up, because some of our weapons are in fairly poor condition. This FAMAS at 87%, for example, but also the TAR at 91 and the FAMAS on Buzz at 93%. These can use some repairs. Also, this helmet should get repaired up, and we have a ton of other things to repair too. So I think we should take 1 hour here, rest up until 1600 hours, and then repair from 4 to 5. This is a good spot to do this in, because we do have this munitions factory available to us as a facility, and this increases your repair speed a lot by 100%. You do need, or the mercenary you set to duty in the munitions factory does require a dexterity of 70 and a mechanical skill of 60, so we can only use this with Murgus and Mad Dog, and Gasket of course, but he's not here, because Ice is short 3 points of mechanical skill, and Bubba is lacking 2 points of dexterity and 1 point of mechanical as well. But we can only use the facility with 2 mercenaries at a time anyway, so Murgus and Mad Dog can do that. Just to quickly show you the effect this has, this doubles the repair speed. I guess Murgus would repair something that is easy to repair next, so that's why it's 15 of 13, and 15 doubled is 30, of course. Alright, but before we do any of that, we do have 14 minutes to check out this sector. Or rather 13, until we need to send everyone to sleep. And what you can also do in this hour is check out the mine, while most mercenaries do something here in H2. We can send someone down to the mine and see what's up there, get some gold out of it. We might be able to get enough money together so we can extend Steven's contract by 2 weeks, which is $26,000. Also, we need to keep these daily expenses in mind. It's almost $3,000 that are deducted at midnight, and we don't want to go below these, because as I've mentioned before, if you go below your if you cannot cover the daily expenses of at midnight, your or the militia men you cannot pay will disband and go home, which is terrible, of course. Also, we need to keep in mind that we do have to pay Hamus with 250 at midnight. So we'll see how much gold we can get out of the mine, and then see about Steven's contract. If it's too close, we'll just give him another 1 day extension and extend his contract by 2 weeks the next day. Our income here through the Grum mine is up to almost $1,300 now, because we do have a control of 40% now. 2/5 of the town are ours, and the loyalty is up from I think 18% to 24 now, so that's a bit more money. And we do get some more income at 1800 hours, so if we repair until 1700 hours, then attack one sector, we'll have a control of 60% and higher loyalty as well, probably around 30%, which means that this goes up to about, let's say, $2,000, probably a little more, but let's say $2,000. That means we'll get 500 of that, because each income tick is 1/4 of the daily income, plus, of course, the regular income here, so that puts us up to about $3,250 more from the daily income. And we are going to find some money here, not too much, but a little anyway, because as you saw here while we were fighting, there are some NPCs here Mickey, I think we already met somewhere else before, but there's another guy called Elgin, whom we'll talk to in a second. And I think that's the first thing we are going to do here. We're going to see about the NPCs here. Let's get down here and over here.
Okay.
Yes.
See, and Razor does need to reload.
I'm listening.
Scope as well. This needs to go back to Razor. And
yes.
Baba, reload too. Let's
you
talk
call?
To the people here.
Will do.
And there's a third NPC, a named NPC as well. Let's have a quick chat with. Oh no, it seems we haven't met him before.
Mickey O'Brien's the name. Pleasure to meet you.
Hello, Mickey.
You look a wee bit familiar. Did I not run into you in me gun running days? Aye, a nasty business that was. Just to be scraping together nickels and dimes here and there. Stumbled upon something a wee bit more lucrative. Animals and their parts. The Asians and bloody collectors pay a fortune for the rare gems of the animal kingdom, and not a bloody one of them is armed at that. I was just passing through, seeing if I could bag myself a couple of elusive blood cat pelts. Those felines can only be found in Arulco, you know. Could I interest you in buying a poor, thirsty brother-in-arms a drink?
Yeah, we'll do that in a moment. As he said, he is going to buy bloodcut pelts if you bring them to him, and he does pay nicely for them. A bloodcut pelt in perfect condition sells for $400. If you have a few of them, that's a nice side income. But he does travel around, so it's not always easy to track him down. And as he mentioned, he used to be a gun runner. He sold guns in Deadly Games, the add-on to Jagged Alliance 1. Oh, by the way, today on the 2nd of June is the 20th anniversary of Jagged Alliance 1's release. So, yeah, happy birthday to Jagged Alliance 1 at this point. And in Deadly Games, the add-on to Jagged Alliance 1, Mickey sold weapons. Just like Tony does in Jagged Alliance 2, but you could only buy pre-configured packages from him. Sometimes there was one useful item you needed, but a ton of other things that you didn't need. For example, he sold two magazines of M16 ammo, but at the same time offered 30 boxes of 38 special ammo. So you couldn't pick and choose, but you could try to haggle with him. You could try to lower the prices, but usually that just pissed him off, and he came back a few days later offering the same package at a much higher price, telling you that he found a competitor who's willing to pay such and such. So, yeah, standard tricks. But sometimes he had some useful items for sale. Alright, that much about Mickey. Let's talk to him some more.
You ask me. There's not a problem that can't be cured by some fine Irish whiskey. Aye, it's not really me line of work. Aye, so that's that then.
Right,
Hello, I'm Manny Santos. Maybe you have met brother of me.
And this is the oft-talked-about Manny. His brother's already warned us about him. He's a bit slow. You can also see that his portrait is a little more haggard. He is the apprentice bartender his brothers talked about, and let's speak with him.
I do this until I learn the trade. Bartending hard, no? You have the liquor, the glasses, the money, much to do. But one day, I, Manny Santos, will be famous bartender like my brothers. I like this place. Charlie, the bartender, he is no mean to me. He teach me how to do job. Yesterday, I learned to make ice. I wonder though, Charlie, sometimes he makes funny drinks. I don't think they could.
That's odd. Let's keep that in mind, that this guy, Charlie, his boss, mixes funny drinks.
I can mix many drinks. Beer, this is my favorite.
Yep. He learned to make ice, and he can make beer, or rather, mix beer, meaning open the bottle. That's very good, Manny.
No, thank you. I am part of the famous Santos Brothers. I just wish to be bartender. I'll be here if you need me.
All right.
Standing by. Done.
See if he has anything else to say.
Could I interest you in buying a poor, thirsty brother-in-arms a drink?
Yeah, in a moment.
The money is the hardest part for me. I only count to five. I work on it, though. I'll be here if you need me.
Okay. And let's speak with your boss as well.
Cheerio. I don't recall we've met. Well, welcome to my bar, then. It's good to have you here. Got a few regulars here, I do. Mostly blokes getting out of the sun. Bloody hot here, I find. I'll leave you be, chap.
He seems nice enough. Standing
by. No, thanks. I wouldn't know what to do with a gun.
Why are you carrying one, then?
I'll leave you be, chap.
Yep, he is...
You called?
He seems nice, but that face looks familiar. Let's talk to this guy. Be careful of Charlie, the bartender. He's prone to violence. Yeah, he seems a bit weird. Let's check our files. And... as you can imagine, he is one of the terrorists here. Sammy Elgin, and he's called the druggist. He is known to kill with lethal chemicals, or with poison. And you can see his convictions as well. So, yeah, these small hints that he mixes weird drinks and that he's prone to fits of rage. Can help you, if you play this for the first time, can help you be suspicious, get suspicious of him and check your intercept files again. Alright, so he is a bartender here, or he poses as a bartender, hiding from Carmen and us. But we should try to get his head then. There are several ways you can do this. You can just try to burst fire him down, before he gets a chance to react, or you can try to gas him, but that sometimes bugs Manny, who doesn't like having this gas cloud in the bar. Also, civilians are always a danger when using gas, because they might wander into it and die, which is not good, of course. But I find it the easiest to just trigger his combat mode with someone.
Yes.
And then
okay.
Wait for him to spend his action points before moving in.
You call?
Let's get people around the corners here so he can't fire at them.
Standing by. Okay.
We don't need too many people. Oh, health for Grizzly. 95, very nice. I think Razor might want to slice and dice him.
Standing by.
Let's get people here. Well, let's be on the safe side. We don't need to be aggressive here. He isn't
ready
to be much of a problem. Let's get these out of sight for a second.
I'm listening. Understood.
And Scope can check this. Well, I think we had some binoculars as well, dropping last time. Oh, and some money. Let's get Scope the binoculars. And the money. We'll distribute the rest of the things later. Oh, 7 smoke shells. That's an interesting loadout. I think it was the elite lady on the roof here. Yeah, that's her. Okay, we don't want to hurt the others, of course. But we do want to get eyes on Charlie.
see about that. Okay, let's to get a little closer here. Where is he lurking?
Ready.
Done. Don't want to be too close because you don't want to have. Ah, there he is.
Ready. Right. I'm on it.
I'm listening.
Just need to get eyes on him from a distance. Right-o. So we can trigger his aggression. Okay, let's see how far
Understood.
Back we can get without losing vision. Okay, now he's
Right-o.
Gone. All right. And you can even go crouched, and you can even go prone. Perfect. That's 32 tiles. Yeah, that's
Ready.
Fine.
I'm on it.
Let's also get someone here to cover.
I made it. Let's do something already.
Oh, and these three have arrived. Let's do this first. Build some tension about the terrorist fight. Yeah, Madoc should travel on so he can use the factory. This we can leave here for the time being. We don't need the RPG. We don't need this and this. You might want to repair this up. We don't need the laser ammo. Oh, we have some more here. This sells for a lot, so we'll keep it here. You could bring this to repair later. Don't need this because we don't have a scope for it anyway, so it's no real use bringing this along. I think Ira needs some of this here. Let's get this on her. You can bring this back. Now we can leave it. We do have enough. You do have some 762x51 in the other sector too. I think that's all we need. He can bring these toolkits for the others. This we don't need here either. All right. Ira can also drop things off. She's fine with the Mini 14. We might need this in the other sector, but we'll keep Ira here. So this can go to Mad Dog. She can keep this for now, just in case. Don't need this. Don't need this, but the rest should be fine. She can start a militia force in this sector in a moment. And Dimitri, he could stay here and repair up some grenades. Let's get this on him. And drop this, he can keep the rest. Let's also get this on him. He can just start repairing some of these things. Yeah, we don't need this pressingly. The rest is fine. He doesn't really need this, but he might pick up a proper small sidearm fairly soon. Could also start repairing up one of these here. Let's keep him where he is. We'll position him once we have enemies close by. Repairs, and all of these can sleep in a second as well. Yeah, we should get militia forces going here, even though the expense might be too much so that we cannot extend Steven's contract, but I'd like to get a militia force up here as fast as possible. At least one group, so we can see the number of enemies in the adjacent sectors. Yeah. And if we cannot extend Steven's contract by 2 weeks right away, that's not a problem. Either we do have a good financial situation now that we have this mine under control. It's more important to be safely able to hold Grum at this point so we don't lose the additional income. Let's start this militia force. And Mad Dog can move on.
You got it!
And Dimitri needs a rest too. Alright, let's continue this here.
I'm listening.
Alright, these are all fine. We do want to make sure that these two don't get hurt.
See? Okay.
Let's just swap them away.
Me, ready.
Out of the potential line of fire here. And we might as well put
standing by.
Murgus
understood
down here as well.
Understood.
Steve is still on the roof, but that's fine. We don't need him here. Let's get Murgus's rifle up. Let's get them back.
Ready.
Don't want the interrupt.
Standing
too
by.
Early.
Yeah.
Yo, taken care of.
All right.
See? Me, ready.
Fit over here.
Me, ready. Okay.
All right, and let's trigger him.
I'm listening.
Combat mode. Well, Manny's wondering about, but that's fine.
See?
That's good. Let's trigger him. Let's see, where is he running off to? Normally, that triggers combat mode, but this time it did not. Let's wait for him move about. Let's get eyes on him again. He's not hostile yet, so we don't really have to worry about it. But you do want to get vision on him from far away. Because the terrorists can be quite nasty. They do take a lot of damage to take down. And you can't really shoot at the head, because if the head gets torn off by the bullet, you can't get any money from killing them.
Understood.
Because you do need the head, and if the head is gone, you can't cut it off as proof.
Righto.
See where he is quickly. I said
understood.
He's not triggered yet. Okay, there
righto.
He is. Alright, I think he's
righto.
Running back. Okay, we can't see him here, that's good. Let's get some more distance, as much as we can. Alright, this should be fine. And we can also go prone here. 32 tiles, yeah,
see?
That's good.
Me, ready.
Let's see, let's do that again.
Bloody bulla bastard! See?
Okay.
I'm listening.
And now Scope can wing him. Oh, I forgot to put the money in the bank. That's fine. Doesn't cost any points. Right, let's take a perfectly aimed shot at his torso. There's not a civilian in sight, so that's good. And then let's just pull her back a tile.
Standing by.
And Razor could just run in and knife him, but I don't want him getting interrupted. He can run up to here though. And let's put the stealth mode on, just for good measure. And let's take a single shot here. Okay, let's take this one. Oh no, he's athletic, he can get far away. Let's get here. Let's get him running.
You called?
And Fox can have some fun as well with her pistols. let's fire at him. And then go prone. Right, he's critical already.
Yes.
So, yeah, let's just run in. Buzz, okay. And see about her shot. Pistol should be better, because the 7x scope is too powerful. Let's fire at him some more. Yeah, we are fine here. Alright, he's down. And now the razor can do the dirty business.
What's that there?
This mean I bartender now, no? Sudden opening is like dream come true.
Well, glad you're happy.
Ready, me, ready.
Standing by.
Ready.
Razor. Well, let's see if he has anything more to say.
Gotcha.
You called? Will do.
I be here if you need me.
Nope, but he does have the buy tab now.
I mix you up nice, no? You tell me what you like.
Right.
Maybe you come back when you're thirsty.
Don't need any of that at the moment, because we do have
ready
the drops here that we can take. Right, and he also dropped a nice rifle. Need to aim for the central point here. Oh, I hope he's not stuck. No, that's fine. Okay. And now we do have his head here. And the money. And this alcohol. Let's give this to Razor. And put it in the bank. And then we'll have a look in the various crates here. And after that, we are going to distribute the items. Put this in the back.
I'm listening. Understood.
Yep, let's get a grizzly in here. Standing to kick
by.
Open these.
Okay.
I'm listening.
Gotcha.
Standing by.
We also have a key.
Nothing.
In the sector inventory. But
you called? We'll do.
Let's see if Fox can't get some training
standing
in here.
By. Blast it!
Standing by. Gotcha.
Start.
You called?
Here.
Sorry, but I can't manage it.
Standing by.
I'm into it.
Blast it!
You called?
It can't be done. Well,
Grizzly can
I
get this open.
Standing by.
With the
way to go, teddy bear.
With the
cool
kicks. And I don't think he can get it open either.
Blast
you
it.
Called?
While using the crowbar.
You called?
Blast it.
Sorry, but I can't manage it.
But it's
way
going to
go, teddy
anyway.
Bear. You
cool.
Called? I'm into
standing
it.
By. Gotcha. Standing by.
Yeah.
Let's get
all
Steven
right.
Down
once there.
Alright. Alright. Standing by. Gotcha.
Another
gotcha.
Helmet.
What's there? Might be worth a look.
TNT.
Understood.
Excellent. We do have a lot of springs.
Nothing.
Yeah,
gotcha.
Things are going to change fairly soon here.
Nothing.
Okay. Okay.
Standing by.
Nothing.
Understood.
Yeah. I must exercise prudence. A sound knowledge of explosives would be helpful here.
Standing by.
All right. Let's see about this one. And I don't trust this either. Let's bring
yes,
in Baba.
I'm okay. Here. I had every dog on the way. There were many.
All right. Mad
yo,
Dog is here.
Taken care of. Ready. Done.
Ready.
Let's get everyone
okay.
Back.
Standing by.
And the key on Grizzly for a second, because he's closest.
I'm listening.
Standing by.
Cool.
Oh, more compound. Very okay. Nice.
You called? Will do.
Yes.
And Bubba's here. Let's remove his explosives. And drop this too.
All right.
Just to be on the safe side. More 40mm grenades.
Doki.
More grenades. Yeah.
Bingo.
Okay.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Yes.
Let's see about this.
Bingo.
All right. Nice work, Bob.
Yes. Okie doki. Okie doki.
And that should be the last crate here. Okay, it's not trapped.
You call?
Let's see if Fox can get it open.
Ooh. Beauty.
There we go. All right. Now we can get our mercenaries into position for the upcoming hour and distribute the loot.
Okay.
Standing by.
Let's drop this and
standing by.
Oh no, yeah. I think Grizzly was the
standing
key
by.
Yeah.
Got it.
Then he can just put it on the key ring. We won't need this key any longer, but still like keeping it around.
Okay.
Right, we can be attacked from the north or from the west. Now let's get
ready.
Into
done.
Quick positions. Don't need to
ready.
Be too precise here.
Yeah, yeah. You got it.
Yo.
I'm listening.
Go.
Yo.
Yeah, gotcha.
Standing by. Okay.
Standing by.
Yes.
Just so we aren't clumped up as
ready.
Much.
Done.
Don't really need to be
done
here.
Yes. Alrighty.
See?
Yeah.
You called? I'm into it.
Okay. Now, I think we saw a second one. And if it does not appear here, it means it is booby-trapped. This is the one in the crate, but there was one more here, I think, somewhere. Where was it here? So we do need to pick this up manually.
Yes!
And Bubba can do that.
Okie dokie!
You can try. He might get hurt, but we don't need him, really, in the next sector. That's
stand
fine. Let's send Grizzly out with
okay.
him so he can patch him up.
Yes.
If he gets hurt. And we
all
are going to do
right.
that next hour because he
all
should get some
right.
more rest.
By.
Send everyone to bed. And set people up right away. So I think this should go to Murgus, and Murgus can pass this to Mad Dog. These two go to the ones who aren't that good at repairing. So Grizzly gets one, and Bubba gets the other once he's... let's give this to him right away. There we go. You can have his things back in a moment. We can use this on a Spectra helmet. Let's see who should get this better helmet. Yeah, Murgus probably. Get this compounded
all up. Right.
And we might as well just use this on the next helmet as well. It's only at 78%, but it's still, once it's compounded, it's better already. And it might get some repair points next hour too. So either Steven or maybe Fox. Let's give it to Steven. Or Ice, maybe. Let's give it to Ice. And compound.
Happening.
Drop this. These are too low, I think. Yeah. But we'll repair these up, of course, and use them in a moment. Lots of 40mm grenades. Perfect. This should be repaired, but the others are in usable condition. This launcher is in great shape. Let's see, I think some of our others were in worse shape. It's not that important with these launchers, but still. We have the option, so why not use it? Ton of ammo here. Let's get this stacked. Resupply scope. She needs some more of these. Let's convert one more. These are easy to transport. They fit in tiny pockets. Let's see about the other launchers. It's also 88. And Murgus should be fine. All right. This is very heavy, 3.5 kilograms. It's a one-shot weapon. You just use it and then discard it. You don't need ammo for it. You can't reload it either. The range is somewhat limited, but the damage it does to tanks is excellent. But as you can see, it's very slow to fire. You basically need a whole turn to fire it aimed, and you do want to fire it aimed and not just willy-nilly. This AKM is the weapon that Elgin dropped for us. It is very similar to the regular AK-47. It's just a slightly modernized version, and it's easier to control in auto fire, and a little faster to bring up, without any drawbacks except for not being as easy to repair as the AK-47. So you see the base stats are the same. The plus one damage comes from the PSO-3 scope, which we could also attach here, so that's not a difference. Range is the same, aim levels are the same, and as I said, AP to ready are slightly lower, and it's easier to control. Instead of 4.11, it's 2 and 10, which is good. I think we might just equip Cliff with it. We do get a lot of repair points the next hour, so I think that this should be fine. Let's get this over to the AKM. And we might use this on someone else. We might give this to... Yeah, we might give this to Meltdown as a rifle now. Yeah, let's... and there's a piece of one on here. That goes together well. This is very slow. It does have a gun barrel extender attached, so it is... nice range wise, but don't think we are going to use it at this point. Cliff does have enough ammo. I don't think he fired last battle, but still, what he did was very important. Keep an eye out and secure the flank. Okay, we can could use this if we need to. Okay, these are all in decent shape. Okay, we might take this with us. There won't be any tanks in Grum, but still, it can also be used against enemies in cover or clusters of enemies. Let's see, I think Camus might grab another of these. This needs to be repaired up. Camus should also get a smoke grenade. We can bring it here. And another smoke grenade who should get this. Meltdown does have the smoke grenade for the launcher, but none to throw. But you do need to think about her inventory now that we have this AK-47 for her. And you should pick up the one of the bipods in the other sector in a moment. Alright, she can also grab one of these. And I think you can leave this here for now. We do have enough better ones now. Yeah, Grizzly can take a second of these. And this might go to Buzz. Let's get this on Buzz. 6 mags are more than enough for her. Grenade-wise, she's fine. She could pick up a smoke grenade, a thrown one as well, once we get another one. She does have the mustard gas, that's fine. Who should get the second set of binoculars? Could put this on Cliff instead of this ammo. But he does have the powerful scope. That should be fine. Or yeah, we could give it to Meltdown. Let's see how we manage with her room. I think she might be better off with another vest. She doesn't really make use of these larger pockets. Let's get let's drop one pistol with her. Get the AK on her with the scope. And we'll pick up a bipod for her in the mine sector once she's had some rest. This looks to be in decent shape. Okay, both 66. And the gas mask, it's in fairly poor shape, but better than this, for example. Night vision goggles. Yeah, Razor can grab these. He's well within his weight limits anyway. This needs to be repaired up. Oh, some armor-piercing 9x19 ammo. That's good. We need to get some ammo on Meltdown, some 7.62x39. I think one stack of two should be fine for her. She does have her pistols for closer engagements. She does need all of this stuff. We can free this one, this slot up. Which pistol to drop? I think we should keep this because we do have some 40 match ammo and 9x19 match ammo is running low. Let's get this in here. Drop this. I think we'll keep the Sphinx for the better accuracy. Doesn't really matter much, but let's get this in here. Put this on here for night fights. Yep, and that's this freed up. I think Scope had one that's not in perfect condition. Yeah. It's the FS, but I said the difference is negligible. It's a little harder to repair, but it's in perfect condition anyway. And this is a little less loud. One point, one tile. So not really a big difference at all. Oh yeah, and we have some more first aid supplies. Get this on Murgus. Yeah. This is at 70. Let's just fill this up. And this as well. Let's fill this. And just fill Grizzlies as well. Any more? No. But two rods. These we can combine with springs to build rod and spring attachments. And this is Elgin's head, which we need to bring to Carmen. And we can give some alcohol to Mickey. Let's have Fox be his drinking buddy in a moment. This we could bring along. Yeah, we could bring it on Grizzly once he doesn't need the toolkit any longer, which would be fine. Let's do the ammo replenishing and then see about what else we need to take care of. It's fine. Ammo for Meltdown. And she does need to free up one slot so she can store the pistol. No, not necessarily. She can also put it in here. If you want to use the launcher, you can do it like this. Yeah, that's fine. So I think Meltdown should be fine now. We do need to bring this ammo. Might give this match ammo to someone else. Or use the last mag of match ammo in here and bring the armor piercing ammo in an extra slot. I'd like to... Oh, we need to bring this, so there's no way around it. We can just give this to someone else. I think that's easier. She can bring some more armor-piercing ammo. Just convert this up. And I think we should give the other two pistol mags to someone else. Let's see about that. Well, Grizzly could load up. Yep, you should do that. You can load up some armor piercing ammo in here. And yeah, Fox as well. Okay. Get this reloaded. Fox. And start away. The binoculars. We could put these on Fox, I think. That might not be a bad idea. Put these on Fox, who doesn't need this much ammo for the pistol any longer. And Murgus should grab some more 40mm grenades. I think one extra mag is fine at this point for the MP5K. Yeah, and let's bring some 9x19 in. Pistol in pistol mag size. Get this on Murgus. Right, almost done now with the inventory stuff. We don't need this, but we can bring some more mini grenades. Yeah, Grizzly might take one of these. And Ice can take this one. Alright, and stun grenades we do have plenty as well. One on Ice. Fox can take one as well. And Steven can take this one. Right, tear gas I don't think we really need any longer, but if we have some room we could bring it. Let's just bring it on Razor. Weight is not an issue with him. Oh, and we need to give him some more 9x19. And he can just bring a brake light here. He's fine with this much 9x19. And Baba will do in a moment, but he could take the Spectra West. These are very sturdy and have a decent coverage for a West, but they do reduce action point cost by 3, just like the Guardian West, and these penalties are, I think, the harshest for any armor. So these are really for the guys who go in and need as much protection as humanly possible. Well, except for the EOD gear, which is atrociously heavy. And if you compound this up, these get even worse. Minus 5 action points, which is not great. Let's get this on him, on Baba. He doesn't need to be fast, he just needs to tank, so to speak. Oh, and we have this here as well, with a 4 grip. Don't think we have... Well, scope might not have one. Yeah, let's get this on here. Don't need the Kevlar stuff. These need to be repaired up. Spectral Leggings reduce action point count by 6. That's pretty bad. But they do have nice coverage, especially compared to the Kevlar Leggings. We're not going to use these, though. Minus 6 is just too much. And you don't need this much protection at the legs. These 23 are fine. These only reduce by 3, action points by 3, and provide 20% camouflage. So that's a worthy trade-off, I think. Let's just get... Nah, you don't really need to bother. You're not going to use Baba if we need to defend within the next two minutes. Oh, and we do have another smoke grenade. Almost overlooked this. Let's see, you should grab this. Ice could take another one, or Fox. But she's getting up there in the weight department. And we don't really have the room on Meltdown. Well, oh, she does have one anyway. Yeah, Murgus can just replace his brake lights here. Alright. Let's get this sorted up. Looking good. Okay, now for a short rest. Murgus and Grizzly can sleep, but that's okay. And we should set people up so they don't bicker. Ice can just repair regularly. Murgus needs to use the facility. And Mad Dog as well. 40 repair points per hour is just crazy. And kit degradation is down to 30% too when using the munitions factory. That's well worth it. Baba can repair later. Right, I think Fox might help out with I think she should go down into the mine, just so she gets some exercise carrying things around. Razor could act as a trainer again in dexterity for Cliff and Buzz, students in dexterity. Hamus, I think, can continue practicing his mechanical skill. Melton and Steven should get a militia force going here as well. Fox is going to go down into the mine. Yeah, Scope might help out Ira with the militia force next hour. But I'd like to keep her here. Yeah, she just in case we get attacked here. Melton can accompany Fox in a moment. And Scope, she does have the teaching trait as well. She can help out with the militia force, while Bubba can repair in a moment. And not only repair, but let's send these out to the mine.
I'm into it.
And Bubba can check on the booby-trapped weapon here. Let's drop this so it doesn't get damaged. Couldn't even spot the booby trap, but that's fine. Right. Let's get Grizzly
standing by
on doctoring duty.
Yes.
Standing by. Standing yes. by.
Takes a while, but should be done in a second.
Yes.
Standing by.
Takes longer than expected.
Okay.
Restarted here. Okay. Usually it does not take this long. Let's just wait.
Yes.
Standing by.
Let's run them back here and see about it again. It's not a terribly bad wound, but I'd still like to get it patched up.
Right.
Standing by.
Yes. All right. Okie dokie.
Standing by.
If this does not work, we can try a different mercenary to patch Bubba up, or just advance the time by a few minutes and try again. Let's wait for the minute to pass and see if it gets updated then. This isn't usually an issue, but apparently this time it is. (Clears throat) as another crate. Let's get someone else.
Yo!
Ready to check on that.
Taken care of.
Yes!
Yo! Taken care of.
Standing by.
Yes!
Yo!
Nothing.
Another one. Okay, not booby trapped. Perfect. Let's see if Ice can't help out Bubba. He doesn't like Bubba, but can still patch him up.
Standing by.
Yo.
I have a feeling that the timer is stuck somehow. Let's wait for a few moments with Ice. Yep, I think it's stuck. Let's just advance time by a minute manually and try this again.
Standing by.
Yo.
Yeah. Now it's working. All right. Never seen that happen before.
Got it covered.
Standing
but,
by.
Yes.
Not a big deal. Okay, now Bubba can pick up his gear again. G41. And his LBE and his Tim's pack and his MP5K. And did he drop anything else? No, I don't think so. Alright, let's set him up as a repair guy, together with Grizzly and Ice again. We could have him patched up, but I don't think that's necessary. Okay.
I'm in position and available, as always.
Meltdown can grab a bipod for the AK. And then help out with the militia training. Don't need anything else from here. Let's get this unloaded just so militia forces can't pick it up. Meltdown. Yeah, Meltdown can help with the militia, and Fox can go down into the mine.
Will do. I'm into it.
And spend this hour getting some
Will do.
Gold for us.
Will do.
Just in case we can transport other things as well that we might find down there. Let's get rid of this. She won't need the ammo down there either. Yeah, that should do. Go to sector. She's here, and let's grab
beauty.
All of another toolkit. See if you can get this open.
Sorry, but I can't manage it. I'm into it.
We'll have to come down with someone stronger.
Will do. I'm into it. Will do.
A6.
Will do. Will do.
That's an interesting thing to say. Very similar to the A sound that they sometimes make.
I'm into it. I'm into it. What's that lying around? I'm into it. Will do. What's that lying around? There's something. I'm into it. What's that lying around? Will do.
And gold is worth a lot. I'm into it. It's really worth coming down here.
I'm into it. Will do. What's that lying around?
Unless you don't need money if you play with fewer mercenaries or just IMP characters, you won't need as much money, of course.
Will do. Will do.
But I like to use more mercs because it's easier to control different areas of a sector. For example, last battle we had Cliff and Hamus. Just
need a moment to catch my breath.
Just to check that one area. That's that one side of the building.
I'm into it.
And if you only have 6 mercenaries and 2 are busy doing something like that, you only have 4 to operate with, and that can easily be problematic. Let's allow her some rest.
I'm into it.
Let's have a walk. Otherwise,
what's that lying around?
Time won't be.
Will do.
Time won't be enough.
Will
to
do.
Check this within 1 hour.
Will do.
And I don't like wasting canteens in real-time mode. That's 4,200 already. Now let's collect this and see how much we get in total.
Will do. I'm into it. I'm into it.
And as you can see, you can get down another level here.
Will do. Will do. I'm into it.
This
What's that
promising.
Lying around? Will do. There's something. Will do. What's that lying around? Will do. There's something. I'm into it.
Yeah, this is faster with more mercenaries, of course, because you can just send them out
Will
in different
do.
Directions. But seeing that we could get attacked in the other sector at any
Will
time,
do. There's
it's
something.
Better to keep as many
What's
of our people
around?
There
I'm into
as
it.
Possible.
I'm into it. I'm into it. Will do.
And you guys can easily skip this anyway.
I'm into it. What's that lying around? What's that lying around? There's something. Will do. Hmm.
2 brake lights.
Got it.
Let's bring these.
I'm into it. I'm into it. I'm into it.
And get down here.
I'm into it. Will do.
As you can see, there's another sector up here.
What's that lying around? Will do. There's something. I'm into it. I'm into it. I'm into it. I'm into it.
Some more crates. Especially if you need money, the gold mine is a true gold mine. You should not pass this up.
Will do. I'm into it. What's that lying around?
Ooh, 4 nuggets.
I'm into it. Will do.
I realized the last 2 parts were very long.
Need a moment to catch my breath.
But I think it's better to keep there one battle as one part. I said you can easily pause in the middle and pick it up another time.
Got it. Beauty. Got it. Will do.
Let's allow her some rest.
I'm into it. I'm into it.
The next parts should be a little shorter, I think. At least 2 of the 3
there's
remaining
something.
Sectors are a little faster to take.
I'm into it. I'm into it.
1 of the 3 remaining does have many buildings, which means
I'm into
we need
it.
To watch many angles and
I'm into it.
Windows and doors, so that's going to take a while as well.
Will do. Will do.
All right, I'll leave this off here. It's a weird point to stop, I know, but I do need to. We'll pick this up next time. I hope you've enjoyed watching this. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.